When you say the words, the Beast of Chess, many people think about these chess players. But in today's video I'm gonna show you why this man right here, Mihail Tal, was in fact the real Beast of Chess. He was born in 1936 and grew up in Riga, Latvia, and for this reason later he received the nickname The Magician from Riga. Why, you may ask? Besides the amazing sacrifices he did and the beautiful style of playing, he also said you must take your opponent into a deep dark forest, where 2 plus 2 is 5 and the path leading out is only wide enough for one. This is some gangster shit. Also, he had an IQ between 170 and 180. He also won the World Chess Championship in 1960, being 23 years old, the youngest world champion to date. A record that would be broken by Garry Kasparov in 1985. So that's being said, let's see how his brutally amazing chess looked like. So, the first game is between Tal and Visvaldi Vedres, who was a Latvian chess composer who sent his first chess assignments at the age of 12, which is pretty impressive if you ask me, because at that age I used to shit myself if I had seen a shadow. Anyway, Tal starts with e4, black responds with a French, and as you can see, after knight c3, knight f6, bishop g5, bishop e7, e5, knight d7, Tal plays h4. We can already see his attacking intentions. Black plays h6, bishop takes, queen takes, and f4, putting extra protection on the e5 pawn, maybe thinking about f5 in the future. Black opens the center with c5, knight e2, knight c6, queen d2, and b5. Black also wanting to attack the queen side. Tal retreats his knight, and after c takes d4, white captures with the knight. Black also takes, queen takes, d4, bishop b7, knight e3, queen c5, and c3. Basically, this move tells black, okay, take my queen, I can beat you in an endgame too. Rook c8, cause why not to put a rook on a kind of a free line. Bishop e2, castle, castle, rook e8, and now h5, white trying to initiate an attack. Queen e7, black thinks he can take advantage of white weaknesses, but he forgets one thing. He's playing with Tal, which is a big mistake. And now white plays rook f3. The idea eventually is to bring the rook in attack. Knight b8, black wants to pursue a maneuver in order to put his knight in a better position. Rook g3, knight c6, queen d2, f5. Now en passant, queen takes, knight g4 bringing his knight in attack too. Queen e7, bishop d3, now even the bishop is looking at the h7 pawn. Rook f8, bishop c2. Now black throws a check, king h2. Man, in this game even the king is moving towards the attack. Queen c4, and now white strikes with f5. Black takes, and now white sacrifices his bishop. The idea is that you can't just take, cause knight h6, check, and the pawn is pinned, you just win a rook. So black brings another rook into the game, and now the queen comes. Usually when you see this many pieces in an attack, it's over. Rook e7, black is trying to defend himself, but it's just not possible, cause after h6, rook f7, the last piece comes in the attack. Rook e1, Tal letting his rook hang, and the idea is that you can take, because after rook takes e1 you have this insane combination. Knight f6, king f8 because you can take the knight, pawn takes, king e7, knight e4, check, rook f6, queen takes f6, king e8, and g8, queen. What the f*** just happened? Anyway, back to the game. Seeing this, black played queen c5, bishop e6, pinning the rook, and black is forced to take. Rook takes, queen f8, trying to defend this position, but here Tal plays rook e8 and black resigns. And why is that? Well, if he takes, you play knight f6, king f8, pawn takes, king e7, knight takes e8, king d7, g8 promoting into a queen, king c8, queen takes f7, king b8, knight d6, bishop c8, the queen from g5 to g8, knight e7, queen takes, I don't know what black can play, maybe b4, and queen takes mate. This is unbelievable. It's to the point when chess becomes art, and that's why I got two more games for you. The second game is actually a blitz game between Tal and Karpov, where white opens with e4 and black responds with the Karokan. So c4 is played, d5, e takes, c takes, c takes, and knight f6 developing the knight. Knight c3, black captures, and white plays knight f3. Black takes the knight, white takes with the b pawn in order to have the center. g6, d4, bishop g7, bishop d3, castle, castle, knight c6, rook e1, rook e8, bishop g5 developing the b. And in the same time pinning the e5 pawn. Bishop e6, and now things get interesting, because in this position Tal plays rook takes e6, sacrificing the rook in order to make black's position weaker. f takes and now you will see how white is adding pressure on the e6 pawn. Bishop c4, queen d6, queen e2, knight d8 protecting the pawn, rook e1, rook c8, knight d2, king h8, black putting his king at safety, knight e4, queen c7, bishop b3, and now e5, breaking the center. Tal plays h4, trying to create an attack. Black takes, and now white, completely ignoring the pawn, plays h5. Black takes, and now after queen takes h5, the queen is evolved. Rook f8, bishop c2, slightly bringing his bishop back into the game. Queen e5, which is a pretty good move, trying to defend and also conquer the center. Now, knight g3, sacrificing his rook and in the same time threatening mate. Karpov takes, king h2. h6, black giving his last breath to fight, but it's useless, cause after bishop takes, king g8, bishop takes g7, rook takes f2, queen h7 check, king f7, queen g6, king g8, white plays bishop h6 check, and Karpov resigns because after king h8, it's mate. This game was just insane, which leads us into the next match. So the third game is between Tal and Mikhail Botvinnik, who by the way was the chess grandmaster who won the World Chess Championship not once but 3 times during his career. The game starts with a French like in the first one, but now with the classical variation to be exact, with bishop b4, e5, c5, a3, bishop takes, pawn takes, queen c7, queen g4, f5, queen g3, retreating the queen, and that's where the theory ends. Basically the two players are now on their own. Black simply develops his knight, and no, he's not drunk, he sacrificed his pawn to open the g-file, so rook g8, queen takes, pawn takes, and now Tal plays king d1, sacrificing his pawn too, and also preventing queen takes c3, forking his rook and king. Botvinnik simply develops his bishop like he didn't even notice a free pawn. Tal gives him a check, knight g6, Tal plays knight e2, wanting to put his knight on f4, putting additional pressure on black's knight. Black plays d3, not even thinking of that pawn, and the idea is after white takes, he will bring his bishop out, and this is actually what happens. White takes and bishop a4 check, king e1. Now black simply takes on e5, white develops normally, trying to bring its pieces to attack the black king. Knight c6, d4, queen c7, retreating his queen. h4, already having ideas of promoting and in the same time overprotecting his bishop. Black decides to open the center, and now white plays rook h3. And the idea is to bring the rook into the game, which is an absolutely beautiful plan. Queen f7, white takes, black takes, and now from nowhere we see that black has 2 pinned knights. How the f*** just happened, don't ask me. Anyway, black plays king d7, unpinning his knight, and Tal just brings the other rook into the game. b6, and now knight f4, attacking black weaknesses. Rook e8, rook b4, bishop c6, queen d1, black takes, rook takes, knight g6, rook d4. Black takes on e3, and after white takes, king c7, and now c4, putting pressure on the d5 pawn. Botvinnik captures, and now after bishop takes, queen g7, and Tal is just winning a rook for a bishop. And after h5, black resigns. Imagine making defeating a world chess champion look so easy. I also hope that my Romanian accent didn't make you very angry. Anyway, thank you for watching. You got the Twitch, the place where I stream, in the description, and also the Fiverr where I give chess lessons. Bye.